From California, it's the Maranatha Concert. 1 hour of the finest in contemporary Christian music. Tonight featuring Leon Patillo, Oden Fong, and the Terry Clark Band. And now the host of the Maranatha Concert, Jim Kempner.
Good evening. We want to welcome you to the concert tonight. We have, I believe, an exceptionally good concert planned out. We have Oden from Mustard Seed Faith. Also a new upcoming artist that's on Good News, Terry Clark, and a band. And Leon Patillo. Our first guest was a lead singer in a real well-known group, rock and roll group, and he's now doing his first album for Maranatha Music. Let's welcome Leon Patillo.
I will make you fishers of men, fishers of men, fishers of men. I will make you fishers of men if you follow me. If you follow me, if you follow me, oh Lord, I will make you fishers of men if you follow me. Come on, we got to get on 2 and 4 really solid now, because that's a soul beat, okay? I will make you fishers of men, fishers of men, fishers of men. I will make you fishers of men if you follow me. If you follow me, oh, if you follow me. I will make you fishers of men if you follow me.
Keep on now.
Fishers of men, if you follow me.
Born again.
Come on, y'all. Born again. born again. I've been born again. Born again. I've been born again.
We'll be back in a moment with Oden Fong on the Maranatha Concert.
Our next guest is one who was the lead singer in Mustard Seed Faith. He's now working on his first solo album, and I think he's one of the best songwriters of this day, especially in contemporary Christian music. Let's welcome Oden Fong.
Jesus Christ and Him crucified for me, about the sins that I did commit, for which Jesus died on that tree. what you'll do for me. Thank God who finally set free. But we love because love comes inside, and we just go along for the ride. We do love, we do love. By His grace, through the faith of His love from above.
Thank you. Thank you.
Servants again, but I know it doesn't matter to you, for you're my closest friend, and I know that I grieve you much when I won't listen to you, and falling down now cause you pain, yet I'm the biggest fool because you only want open the door and show me what my life is for. To feel the emptiness inside, make my face to shine. And only you have felt the pain I felt again and again and again. As I'm going, I'm still growing in your love.
Thank you.
Stay tuned for the Terry Clark Band after this word. Maranatha Music has just released 5 new albums. Isaac Airfreight's new album called Fun in the Sun is a unique Christian comedy album that uses humor to bring Bible principles to life. Here is just a brief glimpse of Isaac Airfreight in action.
Okay, Buck, well, you passed up a great deal there, but don't worry. There's bigger deals yet to come. Okay, Jay's coming out here with a tray. And how would you like to know what's on that tray?
I sure would.
Oh, I'll bet you would, but I'm not going to tell you. But I will tell you that what's on that tray can be yours for that little bag of salvation. What do you say, Buck?
Do I get any clues?
No, it's totally up to you.
Oh,
5 seconds? 2 seconds?
Okay, the bag.
I'm going to keep the bag and trade away the tray.
Changed into his image by the Spirit of God.
Debbie and Ernie also have a new album, and it's called Changin'. The music is fresh, and the lyrics reflect the changes that Debbie and Ernie have experienced in their lives. This is an album you'll be playing over and over.
Empty-handed, oh, that is how he wanted me. He commanded, I left my own plans at his feet.
You've just met John Pantry, an outstanding British musician who has just recorded his first album for Maranatha, entitled Empty-Handed. You'll be anything but empty-handed after you've heard this album.
Trim your sails and turn your ship around to the Lord.
Louis McVeigh is a talented musician whose music became well known when he was with Mustard Seed Faith. His composition, Sail On Sailor, became an instant hit. Spirit of St. Louis is Louis's first solo album, and after one listening, you'll discover who is the real spirit behind Louis McVeigh. That's the sound of Bethlehem, a group of talented musicians that blend the mellow sound of country rock with the good news that Jesus is still alive and able to help you have a better life. We pray that you will enjoy these new albums and share them with your friends and family. The albums are available wherever you buy Christian records and tapes. If your store doesn't have what you want, ask them to order it for you.
Our last guest is one who was in a group called the Liberation Suite that was based out of England. He's also the keyboard player in the Chuck Gerrard Band, and now has released his own album. Let's welcome Terry Clark.
It's good to be free in the Lord. It's good to have the unreligion religion, where you can be free in the joy that's available straight from the throne room of heaven. And in Jesus, we found that. And we enjoy that if we allow ourselves to. And I think all through Scripture, we find little excuses to, I guess the world would say, make fools out of ourselves. But it's more than that. David used to dance and sing before the Lord and lost a few wives as a result, because they thought he was pretty foolish. But we can be foolish before the Lord and really give ourselves. And Psalms 100 says, make a noise. And I'd like for you to stand up and let's make a noise.
Sing along if you know it.
Mansfield. Take that, devil. We're going to have a good time. You know, Jesus is the only one that can turn down that merry-go-round. We've all got our little trips that's easy for us to get on. You know, we probably have different ones in this generation than we did the last generation, but there's always a tendency for humans to get their security from what they can see closest to them, or something that they can go after and grasp as theirs, such as a career or an education, or maybe just acceptance with those around them. But those things always take us on little circles, because they can't really get us anywhere. Jesus is the only one that can straighten out that path, because his value systems are such that there's some substance to it. There's a one step after the other kind of thing. It's not, you know, do your own thing kind of thing. There's a real way to get real life through the real Jesus. And if we can turn over our lives to him and let him worry about managing it, then he can make straight the path, you know. And he can take off these trips. We can get off of the merry-go-round and start putting things first that ought to be first. When Jesus was asked what's first, he said, your relationship with your Heavenly Father. Love him with all of your strength, all of your mind, your body, and your soul, 24 hours a day. And Jesus was the example for that. He was the example for anything you want to find. He said the second one was just like that, in that it had to do with the relationship. The second most important thing is your relationship with one another. One of the prime examples that he gave us was one of giving ourselves for somebody else. That's what this song says, right from his heart. There's time enough. No matter how heavy your schedule gets, don't start cutting out your relationship with God. Don't start cutting out your relationship with one another. Because there's nothing more important than those two things. There's time enough. Feel around until you touch someone. Make them burn their bridges for your smile. Take them in your arms until their tears are gone. It will only take a little while. There's time enough to give yourself, to feel you've helped someone. There's time enough to take your love off the shelf. Stop thinking of yourself and what you've done. And love someone. Take some time out just to think of someone else. You may find another kind of love. Make them count on you each time they need your help. 'Cause that's what real love is made of. There's time enough to give yourself. There's time enough to take your love off the shelf. Stop thinking of yourself and all you've done. And love someone.
Have you ever gone to a Christian with your hard times of life, the things that are just really pressing, and you're looking for some practical answer that'll just all of a sudden, you know, you look at their life and you see that they have it together, You know that there's something special about their life, and you know that you really do need wisdom and direction in life. And so you think that by going to the Christian that you're going to get some insight into life that's all of a sudden just going to make it all seem simple. And so you go to him and you say, oh, you know, my marriage is breaking up, my husband's going out on me, the kids don't come home at night, they're getting D's, the cat's got fleas. Life is so bad. And they look at you and they say the most frustrating things. Why don't you try Jesus? And you go, oh, why don't I try Jesus? Why can't they be practical? Well, what's God going to do in my marriage? How is he going to be helping me out in it? And they might tell you, well, after all, he introduced the first couple and performed the first marriage. Or they come to you and you go to them and you tell them that you have financial problems. The rent's due. They're going to repossess the car. You can't go to school and work too. And it's such a frustrating situation. And you go to a Christian, what do? They tell you to put your trust in Jesus. I mean, after all, it's a real world out there with people and problems. But you see, it is a real world out there with real people and real problems, but there's another thing that's real out there, and that's the devil. Satan, he's called the god of this world, and he just loves to mess with your head. And he'll do all he can to make life miserable for you. But you see, there's also a real God. And he's the only one that knows how to put the devil in checkmate. He's the only one that knows how to corner him so he has no way to put havoc in your life. And it seems so simple. All these problems, and you expect just, you know, 10 pages written out on how to get out of this situation and what to do about it. And they tell you to put your trust in Jesus. There's a story of a man who got caught in the desert, in the wilderness. And it was so hot, and he was walking through this desert, and it, you know, his mouth was getting dry, he could just taste the cotton in it, and lips are getting chapped, and the sun's beating down on him. And he's beginning to die of thirst. And he bumps into a salesman in the middle of the desert. And this salesman says, I'd like to sell you a necktie. And the man says, I'm in the middle of the desert, dying of thirst, and you want to sell me a necktie. That's absurd. You're ridiculous. The guy says, okay. And the guy goes on and on. And finally, his mouth is so dry and he's so thirsty, and all of a sudden, he sees a beautiful tavern. And he knows that there's Cokes and all kinds of drinks in there. And he sees the cars parked outside, and he runs up and he bangs on the door and he goes, oh, I'm dying of thirst, let me in. And the guy at the door says, I'm sorry, we don't let anybody in without a necktie. You see, the Bible says to seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. And many times you're looking and you're relying upon your own logic, when in your own logic you've already failed, and what you want is more logic to fail again. And God comes to you, and by his Spirit he leads people into your life, and they're telling you to turn your life over to Jesus Christ. And it gets so frustrating, and it comes to a point where, you know, you think those Christians are brainwashed. Well, they are. But they got to choose who washed their brains. You see, we tried the Lord in our life. And many of us had just so little faith the night we turned our life over to Christ. We had many doubts, some more than others. Many had more messed up lives than, you know, many of their friends. And yet, God met the person where they were at, and He changed them. He takes us right where we're at, and He changes us. In Luke 17:33, the Bible says, "Whoever tries to keep his life shall lose it, and whoever loses his life will preserve it." You see, you can try all you want. It's like the boy at the dike. The leak started coming, he put one finger in, and a leak over there, and he sticks a toe in, and a leak up there, and he's trying to hold it in. And finally, you know, you only have so many toes, so many fingers. You stick your head, you know, and that's it, man. You can't plug any more holes in your life, and it's still leaking. You're still not happy. You still realize something's not right. The Bible says if you try and save your life, you're going to lose it. But if you'll lose your life, not give up your life and go commit suicide, but if you'll give your life to Christ and let Him be responsible for your life, you'll preserve it. Jesus said, the enemy of this world in your life tries to rob and to steal and to kill the things that God wants to do in your life. But Christ says, I have come to give you a life and that more abundantly. If you let go and let Christ just come in, let Him do what He wants to do. In Romans 8:32, it says that God freely gave us His Son, sent His Son in this world to die for our sins, that we might be restored into fellowship with Him. Not only does He love you, not only does He give His very best for you, but it says how much. Now, He did this for us when we were still in sin. We were still separated. We were still going our own way. God did that for us. How much more after we turn our life over to Christ will He freely give us all good things? God doesn't want to take stuff away from you unless it's going to hurt you. And being a Christian is hard at times. But it's still the truth. And you have to search your heart. Do you want truth? Are you willing to be honest with God and realize your need for Him? Because someday you have to meet Him. And you can either be clothed in the righteousness of Christ and have your sins forgiven and be restored into an experience and a fellowship with God, or you can go your own way and forever be without your Maker. Because the decision you make for Jesus Christ is an eternal decision. And if you make it against Him, the doors of heaven are forever barred from you. And that's a heavy thing. But like the one brother said, God came to share His love, not His wrath. His wrath is only for those who reject His love. Tonight, if you want Christ, if you want that life, don't put it off any longer. You're just going to spend more time messing it up, just plugging another hole in the dike. Come home. Let Christ come in and do what He wants to do in your life. Know what it is to have fellowship with the Creator of the universe and say yes to Jesus Christ. Let's pray. Father, we thank You for Your love. We thank You, Lord, that in many different ways You communicated what You've done through Jesus to us. We thank You for the people that You brought our way to tell us about Your way home. Tonight, Father, we lift up those who still need You, who still are trying to plug the dike and looking for answers and doing it every way but the way that You've provided for man. Father, we pray that You'd bring them home tonight. Give them the faith that gives them eternal life in Jesus Christ. While our heads are bowed and our eyes are closed, You're here tonight because you need Jesus Christ. You're here tonight because God loves you, and through many different ways, and some of you so stubborn, God brought you here so that you could hear and know that there's a way out, a way through Christ. Father, we pray for these that want you, that want the life that's in Christ. Father, we just lift them up, that you would give them the faith to make a confession of you. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to the Maranatha Concert. Whether you've accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior for the first time tonight, or have known him all your life, we have a special gift for you. It's a Christian survival kit. It contains practical information that will help you have a joyful, victorious life. In the kit, you'll find an easy-to-follow Bible study series covering such subjects as relating to God, relating to people, trials and temptations, and how to live a successful Christian life. You'll also receive a copy of our Last Times newspaper and an illustrated version of one of the most exciting sections of the Bible, the Gospel of John. And finally, each survival kit includes this free long play record album entitled Saturday Night Live. It features outstanding performances from 14 different artists, including Daniel Amos, Karen Lafferty, Debbie and Ernie, Kelly Willard, Bethlehem, Isaac Airfreight, and more. To receive your free survival kit, simply send us your name and address along with the channel number or call letters of the station you're now watching. Just write to Survival Kit, care of Maranatha TV Concerts, Box 1396, Costa Mesa, California, 92626.
It's been a very inspiring concert tonight. We want to thank our guests, Oden Fong, Leon Patillo, and Terry Clark, for being with us. We want to thank you for joining in the concert with us also. If you haven't as yet turned your life over to Christ, the Bible says to seek him while he may be found and call upon his name while he's near. And right where you're at, you can just say, Jesus, I'm asking you to come in and to take over my life. I know that I've sinned and I need you in my life. And Jesus said, whomever calls upon me, I won't turn him away. We encourage you to do that. Till next week, same time and same station, good night and God bless you.
The executive producer of the Maranatha Concert is Chuck Fromm. The concert is produced and directed by Richard Eisleben. The associate producer is Dick Koth. The Maranatha Concert is a presentation of Maranatha Music. For more information, please write Maranatha Music, Post Office Box 1396, Costa Mesa, California, 92626.